This portion of the show is brought to you by Dr. Edward Ruiz Dental Services, located at 17901 Governor's Highway, Suite 201 in Homewood. Stop in today for their simple and comfortable in-office laser whitening. Mention Windy City Poker Championship and receive a free cosmetic dentistry consultation, a $65 value. For more information or to make an appointment, call them today at 708-798-8899 or log on to www.dentistryil.com.
Come all in.
New location, new players, amazing poker. That is what you can expect from Windy City Poker Championship as we bring you the hottest poker tournaments in Chicago. On our program, we have poker legend TJ Cloutier taking on Chicago's best players as we raise money for kids with cancer. Hello, Chicago, and welcome to another Windy City Poker Championship. I'm Michael Lapidus. This is Kirk Falla, and we're in the financial district of downtown Chicago at the Cactus Bar and Grill.
Michael, as usual, we're here to support local charities in Chicago. We're back with the Treasure Chest Foundation. Now, they're an organization that sends presents to kids with cancer throughout the United States.
Well, I have been walking around this tournament, and I've seen some industry giants here tonight, Kirk.
Michael, the WPT Bootcamp Pros are in the house tonight playing here for the charity event. I was actually with them earlier this afternoon at the WPT boot camp, and the skills that they taught us there, they're applying here tonight.
Oh, that is gonna be great. Well, let's meet the players.
In position number one is Brian White. Brian was our seventh place finisher at our last Windy City Poker Championship. He's hoping to have some better luck this time as he sits down at this final table in sixth place with 41,000 in chips. Next to him in position number two is a familiar face to Windy City Poker Championship, Todd Murray, who took second place at our last event. Last time he came as the short stack, this time he's second in chips with 101,000. To Todd's left in position number three is Gino Francone. Now Gino's hoping to make a name for himself both in the car business and here at the Windy City Poker Championship. He's our current chip leader with 154,000 in chips. Sitting next to Gino in position number four is WPT Bootcamp's TJ Cloutier. A former football player and current professional poker player, TJ is third in chips with 76,500. To TJ's left in position number five is Alan Wabey. He is currently the short stack with 32,000 in chips. In position number six is the rookie here at the final table, Walter Bustos. This is Walter's second tournament. Now he has been playing poker for about 6 months, he says. He is currently in fourth place with 74,500 in chips. And finally in position number seven is Ben Marcello. He's an IT consultant from Chicago. Ben is currently in fifth place with 44,000 in chips.
All right, Kirk, we're here at the final table here at the Cactus Club, a real neat new venue.
It's a beautiful place, Michael, and it's a beautiful night, and we have some great poker going on for the folks at home.
We also have some interesting people at the table here.
We have two returning players from our last program who made the final table, plus a poker professional. TJ Cloutier from the World Poker Tour Bootcamp is at the final table. This is phenomenal.
Man, that guy is tall. All your years of writing fan mail and trying to contact this guy, he's
luck,
playing
man.
In this tournament.
Hey, I'm persistent. I was writing him letters for like 12 years.
He is here with bodyguards to make sure that you don't attack
TJ's
him.
TJ's his own bodyguard. The man's 7'10". Blinds are at 3 and 6,000 with a 500 chip ante. Todd is first to act. Our silver medalist from our last show, 5'2 suited. He's not going to play. Over to our poker pro, TJ Cloutier, pocket threes.
Hey, crabs, as I like to call them.
20,000.
He's going to raise it, make it 20,000 all day. 2.5 times the big blind. It's going to push out anybody with marginal hands.
Some serious poker right away.
Over to the big blind, Brian White. He's got ace-8 suited. They call that the dead man's hand.
Can't take on a pro in my first hand.
That's right, Brian. If you knock out TJ, you're dead to me, buddy.
Hey, Kirk, why don't you stick to putting sugar in the gas tank?
What kind of car does Brian drive?
Looks like a Fiat.
I was here a couple weeks ago, made the final table, so looking to do a little better. Last final table, I came in a little short stack. I had to make a move. I pick up a pocket pair.
And here we go to the flop. Jack, boy, queen, good. 10.
Oh.
Wow. Oh. Brian flops a set, and he's not happy.
He's not happy at all. The glasses came off.
Todd is well behind in the hand, but he flopped a gut shot straight draw.
Look at that. That gives Todd the straight.
I'm a little better now. I'm still short stacked, though. Not a lot. But my strategy is pretty much the same. I try and lay low the first couple rounds, play a little weak, then when you make your moves later on, they tend to be worth more.
Well, Brian is in sixth place in the second hand here at Windy City Poker Championship.
Michael, it's a different crowd here at the final table, so we'll see how Brian does here at the Windy City Poker Championship.
Well, the cards are dealt. Gino's first act. He has Jack 9 offsuit. He's going to fold.
10-4 for TJ, the trucker hands. You know, TJ looks like he could be a trucker.
He probably was in a former life. Alan folds with a 6-3 offsuit. Our rookie folds.
He knows not to play 5-3 offsuit.
And we have Benjamin Button. I mean, sorry, Kirk. We have Ben on the button.
He's got queen 10 of hearts.
12,000.
It's a decent hand to play in this position.
I'm out.
Oh.
Todd in the big blind. He's got 7-5 offsuit. Now he's already got 6,000 invested in this hand. He's going to get good pot odds if he makes this call. Todd's going to make the call, and we're going to be heads up to the flop.
That flop is a Jack 8-3 suited.
Ah, check your whole cards. Who's got a club?
Well, Todd's going to check.
That's a scary board for both players.
Ben's checking right behind him.
Turn brings a Jack of hearts. That pairs the board, making it less likely that either player might have a Jack. So we're going to see a river here, Michael. The river brings a Queen of diamonds. That gives Ben the best hand with a pair of queens.
Well, the only way Todd's going to win this hand, Kirk, is if he bets Ben out of here.
That's right, Michael. He's going to make a bet of 15,000, which is half the pot.
Is that enough?
I call.
Call you win, sir.
And he makes a reluctant call, but it turns out that's pretty good for him.
That's right. Ben's got the best hand. He makes the call, and he's going to win that pot. Todd took a stab at it, but missed. 7 high, no good.
Congratulations, Ben.
They're all great players. I've seen them before in previous tournaments, and I think it'll be a good matchup. I'm going to try to stick with what I've been doing all night as far as just playing my cards as opposed to playing people, just focusing on not getting too greedy.
Well, Ben's hoping to catch some cards tonight and reap the rewards of being a Windy City Poker